This is a game that frogs play whenever they are not being witnessed by humans. And the way that they play it, you can imagine that these are lily pads, and there's five frogs. Five frogs that want to have a party on the same lily pad. One frog jumps one space. Two frogs jump two spaces. One frog jumps one space. We've got four frogs on here, so four frogs jump four spaces. These frogs are happy because they are celebrating a party on their own lily pad. Now it's your job. You have to figure out, is this possible? The day after, whenever a new frog comes to town. Is this possible? One extra rule. You cannot jump frogs onto an empty lily pad. So I could jump one frog there. I could jump one frog here. I could jump one frog here. And two frogs I could jump here. Four frogs must jump four spaces. One, two, three, four. Oh, this is an empty lily pad, so we can't do that. So this is an example of a failure. Can we manage to do this with six frogs on six lily pads? Can we manage to do this with n frogs on n lily pads? So this is a puzzle that doesn't have an obvious answer. Before we solve six, I want you to imagine you've only got two lily pads and two frogs. Well, that's easy to solve. So now we're going to use that, and I'm going to split this into two. I'm first of all going to solve the left, and then I'm going to solve the right in exactly the same way. This looks suspiciously similar to having two frogs and two lily pads. Here we have three frogs and three frogs separated by three. So this can be solved in exactly the same way as two frogs can be solved on two lily pads. So now that we've solved six, is it easy to solve 36? Of course it is, because we can design 36, we can solve for this six in the same way. We can solve for this six, this six, this six, this six. We've solved for all of the sixes. We now have six stacks of six, all separated by six. Then it's just kind of like a giant six. It doesn't just give us the solution for even numbers, it also gives us solutions for numbers like nine, three times three, because you could imagine with nine, we solve like this. Okay, now you can see we've really got a big version of just the three. So we do the same thing. We've solved it. Can we solve for prime numbers?
Can we solve for prime numbers?
So the answer is yes. And let me show you, this is another, you should take time and try to solve for prime numbers, but let's extend this. We'll go to 11 here. I'm gonna show you how to do it, and you'll immediately see that you can do all integers. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Solved. That will work for everything. To make the problem a little bit more interesting now that we've solved for every integer, now what we're going to do is we're going to say, well, one of these frogs is actually the queen frog. And the queen frog must always be on the top of any pile. So you can think, can you solve for that always? So for example, you could go two here, but then you couldn't move this one on top of the queen. You could move two here. This then becomes a challenge. Is this always possible? And is it always possible no matter where the queen is? If the queen starts over here, is this possible? So you should take a moment and you should figure out, is this possible or impossible? What I'm going to try to do is I'm going to use this same technique of back and forth and back and forth and back and forth, And I'm going to end up here. Right, so let me do that first. So what do I need to do now? I need to somehow end up on this place here. And that is doable by the same technique. I go back and forth. I'm going to start here, and I'll go back and forth. And just by choosing correctly, I can make sure that this stack is going to end up on top. So this is also solvable for all integers. A little bit less obvious. Now let's remove the queen and give instead a lazy toad. Where would you like the lazy toad to be?
Let's put it in the third position there.
Okay. So the lazy toad doesn't move. So we have got to have the party on this lily pad. Is this possible? So take a second, try to figure out, is this always going to be possible or not? And the answer is yes, this is always going to be possible in the same with the same system. So here I'm going to choose this one, I'm going to move over here and go on top. Here I'm going to choose something in the middle, and you just have to figure out, do I want to jump this way? Yes. So I jump this way. And we've solved it. And this is solvable for all integers. You might want to experiment with one lazy toad and one queen that has to be on top, and everything else frogs, and see if that is possible. Sometimes it's possible, sometimes it's not. Now I'm going to share a problem that I don't know the answer to. And this one, we have the frogs, and unfortunately, two of the lily pads are waterlogged. The end, the one second from the end on either side. So no frogs can go on here. I do not know if this is ever solvable for any number of lily pads. I've never been able to solve a single one of these. So that's my open problem here. I'll show you a failure. So I need to get this frog somehow because it can't move here. So I need to go over and grab it. So let me grab it by this technique. I'll go 2, that gives 3. Now I come over here, that's 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I can come over and rescue this one. Now that's 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm stuck here. I've got this one by itself now. What can I do? Well, I can at least get this one. But then that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can't move this stack, because that goes onto the waterlogged lily pad. I can't move this stack, 1, 2, 3, and I can't move this stack. So I'm stuck here. So I've never been able to solve any of these for any length, but it's not obvious at all that this can't be solved for some length of lily pads. Just the one away from the end on each side being waterlogged. 16 is not low enough. So what could we do? We could split this into an 8 here, and a 12, we could do that. And so now our score is 12 minus 4 is equal to 8.